السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. To carry on with the upper limb lectures, I'm going to discuss in this presentation the anatomy of the muscles of the front of the forearm. I'm Dr. Dalia Saleh, professor and head of anatomy department at Mansoura University, Egypt. The objectives of this presentation will include the muscles of the front of the forearm, including the superficial and the deep groups. The muscles of the front of the forearm are arranged into two groups, a superficial group and a deep group. The superficial group includes the pronator teres, the flexor carpi radialis, the palmaris longus, the flexor digitorum superficialis, and the flexor carpi ulnaris, while the deep group includes the flexor digitorum profundus, the flexor pollicis longus, and the pronator quadratus. The superficial group of muscles of the front of the forearm consists of five muscles, as I mentioned before. They all have the same common origin from the front of the medial epicondyle of the humerus. Their insertions differ, but we can predict the site of their insertion according to their names. They are all supplied by the median nerve, except the flexor carpi ulnaris from the ulnar nerve. They are all flexors to the joints they are crossing, like the elbow, the wrist, or the fingers, except the pronator teres, which also performs pronation of the forearm. In this simple diagram, we can see the humerus, the ulna, the radius, the carpal bones, and the fingers here. And this is the articular disc between the ulna and the carpal bones. This is the medial epicondyle of the humerus, which will give the common origin of these superficial group of muscles. So, first we have the pronator teres, the flexor carpi radialis, the palmaris longus, the flexor digitorum superficialis, and the flexor carpi ulnaris. Note that their origin arises from the common flexor origin, while their insertion differs. If we look at this diagram on the right side of the screen, if we locate the medial epicondyle, so this will be the common flexor origin. So, this muscle will be the pronator teres, the flexor carpi radialis, the palmaris longus. On a deeper plane lies the flexor digitorum superficialis, and the one on the medial side will be the flexor carpi ulnaris. The pronator teres arises by two heads, one from the humerus, from the medial epicondyle and the medial supracondylar line, and also from the ulna, from the coronoid process of the ulna as well. Its insertion into the middle of the lateral surface of the radius. Since this muscle crosses the elbow joint, so it helps in flexion of the elbow joint. Also, it pronates the forearm at the radio-ulnar joint. For the flexor carpi radialis, it arises from the medial epicondyle of the humerus from the common flexor origin and inserts at the base of the second metacarpal bone. It acts by flexion and abduction of the wrist. We also call it radial deviation. The palmaris longus originates from the medial epicondyle of the humerus from the common flexor origin. It inserts into the flexor retinaculum and the palmar aponeurosis, so it does not have a bony attachment. When it contracts, it flexes the hand or assists in flexion of the hand. It is a weak flexor of the hand, and also tightens the palmar aponeurosis, as when you are making a fist or making a grip. The flexor digitorum superficialis arises by two heads. One is called the humero-ulnar head, from the medial epicondyle of the humerus and the coronoid process of the ulna, and also by a radial head from the upper half of the anterior border of the radius. It inserts at the bodies of the middle phalanges of the medial four fingers. At their insertion, their tendons split to give passage for the deeper tendons of the flexor digitorum profundus. The action of this muscle is to help in flexion of the proximal interphalangeal joints and the metacarbophalangeal joints of the medial four fingers, and also assist in flexion of the wrist. For the flexor carpi ulnaris, the most medial muscle of the superficial group, it also arises from the medial epicondyle of the humerus and from the medial border of the olecranon process of the ulna, and also from its posterior border. It inserts at the pisiform bone, the hock of hamate, and the fifth metacarpal bone. This muscle causes ulnar deviation or adduction of the wrist and also helps in flexion of the wrist as well. It consists of three muscles. The flexor digitorum profundus arises from the ulna, the flexor pollicis longus arises from the radius, and the pronator quadratus arises from both radius and ulna. They are all supplied by a deep branch of the median nerve, it's called anterior interosseous nerve, except the medial half of the flexor digitorum profundus, which is supplied also by the ulnar nerve. Back to our model, this is the humerus, ulna, and radius, the carpal bone, the fingers, and the disc between the ulna and the carpal bones. So the flexor digitorum profundus arises from the ulna and splits into four tendons for the fingers. The flexor pollicis longus arises from the radius and gives a tendon that is inserted at the thumb. The pronator quadratus attaches to both radius and ulna. So this is the origin of the flexor digitorum profundus. Insertion into the distal phalanges of the fingers, the origin of the flexor pollicis longus and insertion at the distal phalanx of the thumb, and this is the attachment of the pronator quadratus. Flexor digitorum profundus, and we should know that profundus means deep because it lies deep to the flexor digitorum superficialis. It arises from the upper three quarters of the ulna and the interosseous membrane, while its insertion into the pases of the distal phalanges of the medial four fingers. From its name, it flexes the interphalangeal and the metacarbophalangeal joints and also the wrist. The flexor pollicis longus, and pollicis refers to the thumb. It originates from the anterior surface of the radius below the anterior oblique line and also from the interosseous membrane. Its tendon is inserted at the base of the distal phalanx of the thumb, and its action is to flex the joints of the thumb. The pronator quadratus originates from the oblique ridge on the lower part of the anterior surface of the ulna, while its insertion into the lower fourth of the anterior surface of the radius. Again, from its name, it causes pronation. This is the supinated position of the forearm. Upon contraction of the pronator teres and pronator quadratus, the radius will rotate at its superior and inferior radioulnar joints, causing pronation. This will be the end of my presentation. Thanks for listening. If you like it, please do not forget to subscribe, like, and share, and do not forget to hit the notification bell so you can know if I upload another video. Please feel free to leave a comment below. See you in the next video. Thank you.